The AI race is heating up, and Google is finally back in a game with Bard. This comes at a time when AI tools are becoming increasingly central to our daily tasks. If you're anything like me, you've probably been using ChatGPT on a daily basis since the day it was released. It's been my go-to solution for anything I don't know or any problem I can solve. More often than not, it's the only tab I have open in Chrome. You can be sure Google is clearly aware of this shift because they mentioned AI over 140 times in their recent keynote. And although most of these announcements are still on the horizon, they did sound convincing enough for me to give their latest offering a chance. So for an entire week, I decided to switch my bookmark in Chrome from ChatGPT to Google Bard and compare them side by side in real-world scenarios to help you determine whether or not Google Bard is a viable alternative for your specific use case. And the results, I think, might surprise you. Let's dive in. The most important announcement from the whole 2-hour keynote was the unveiling of the Palm 2 model, which already powers Google Bard. According to its research paper, Palm 2 is much better at coding than the previous version. It also excels at multilingual tasks, supporting 180 languages. It provides more accurate responses in certain languages than ChatGPT and even better translations than Google Translate. However, as of now, only English, Japanese, and Korean are supported in Bard. I immediately tested it on several basic math problems that the previous version struggled with. I was pleased to see that it finally managed to solve them. Similarly, it successfully debugged some basic Python code, a task that the previous version fell short on. One notable difference between the newer version of Bard and ChatGPT is the Bard's knowledge cutoff. The point up to which it has been trained on data has been extended to February 2023, a few years beyond the ChatGPT's cutoff. This enables Bard to provide information on the latest features of certain codebases, such as the app directory in Next.js 13. Additionally, browsing capabilities which allow Bard to pull in information from the internet are now enabled by default. This means that questions like what was the name of the latest SpaceX rocket can now be answered accurately and with sources cited. Furthermore, Bard offers voice-based interaction, much like the one we made in a previous video, which is extremely convenient. Moreover, it can even read images, much like what we were promised with GPT-4, but still never got a chance to experience. The main drawback of Bard is its tendency to fabricate information when the context is lacking. However, it's important to note that the version of Palm 2 that powers Bard is much smaller than even GPT 3.5 Turbo, and Google has already announced a few other versions. The largest one, Unicorn, should become comparable in size to GPT-4, while the smallest one, Gecko, should be small enough to run even on mobile devices locally. Overall, Google has made substantial progress in an extremely short amount of time, transforming Bard from an almost unusable tool to a worthy competitor to ChatGPT. So now, let's see how it would perform in my day-to-day tasks during a week. As a full-time freelancer, I use ChatGPT mostly as my virtual assistant, so the most common task is, of course, answering emails. ChatGPT is an amazing tool that helps me do this. I use simple prompt with the promptable Chrome extension to make the process even easier. Bard performed nearly as well. I would say that I still prefer ChatGPT over Bard because Bard sometimes includes information that I did not intend to include. However, if you explore other drafts, you can almost always find one that will work just as well. It also offers the option to export your draft to Gmail directly, which is very convenient. One big disadvantage, however, is that Bard does not currently have chat history. Nevertheless, for drafting emails, I had no problems during the week after switching to Bard. The second most common task I perform with ChatGPT in my business is to assist me in writing boilerplate code. Bard has made significant improvements since the last version, and while it is still far from GPT-4, it is now a worthy competitor to ChatGPT for this task as well. Of course, you still need to double check the code before using it, but basic tasks like creating a cloud function or processing data from a CSV file, Bard can now complete with ease. Where it truly shines compared to ChatGPT is in scraping websites. Since it has internet access, you can ask it to create a scraper that parses a specific URL, then paste that URL and there you have it, an instant web page scraper that extracts the content that you need. Additionally, you can verify the accuracy of the response by comparing the code in drafts. If there are significant differences between them, it is possible that one of them or all of them are incorrect. Overall, if you're not generating code for your job and you don't have to worry about deleting your company's production database, Bard is more than enough. However, for me, the problem was that it often could not satisfy all the requirements for more complex problems. Another one of my daily tasks is creating content. I don't ever ask the model to generate a whole article or script for me, instead I use them to refine it. Nevertheless, I also tested BART for full article generation and found that it is not as effective as ChatGPT at generating lengthy texts. Despite trying various prompts, I was unable to produce a sufficiently long result. According to Google Cloud Pricing, the Bison model that BART currently uses can handle a maximum input of 4096 tokens, however it can only output 1024 tokens, or roughly 750 words. This means that while it can handle more text than GPT 3.5 Turbo at once, its output is limited. Therefore, if you want to generate a full article, use ChatGPT instead. However, for generating ideas and editing text, BART was great due to its speed advantage. So now, let's consider all these factors and try to determine which model will be better for your specific use case. When I embarked on this experiment, I did not believe that I could last a week without ChatGPT. However, much to my surprise, BART proved to be a viable alternative. Yes, overall the quality of responses is lower, but it makes up for it with the extra features like multiple drafts, internet access, image processing, and later knowledge cutoff. Besides, most importantly, you get all these benefits for free. You see, ever since its launch, I've been an active user of ChatGPT Plus. Before that, the free version of ChatGPT was almost unusable due to the delays. BART, on the other hand, is completely free and nearly as fast as the paid ChatGPT Plus. In my view, ChatGPT is still superior, but only if you're using the paid version. If you're not inclined to spend an extra $20 per month, you should consider using BART, or even better, a combination of both. For example, for short tasks that are easy to verify, such as drafting emails, you can confidently use BART. However, for more complex tasks, such as generating code, I would still recommend using ChatGPT. This approach allows you to leverage the strengths of both chatbots, therefore boosting your productivity. Personally, I will stick with ChatGPT Plus because of the additional benefits offered by GPT-4, which is on a completely different level for coding. However, the overall decision ultimately depends on your budget and what you're looking to achieve. Given the amount of data OpenAI has collected from their first mover advantage, I suspect Google will struggle to match them in terms of performance for years to come. Nevertheless, as these models grow larger and the cost of running them decreases, the differences may become subtle or even unnoticeable. The winner of the AI race may not necessarily have the most powerful model, but instead they could offer the most convenient integrations. In this regard, Google certainly has an edge. Even at its current stage, if I could use BART within Gmail, I wouldn't bother to open a separate tab for ChatGPT. As a result, I believe that the choice of the model will become less apparent to the end users over time, as these models will be seamlessly integrated into our everyday products. The decision will instead depend on which software you prefer. Those who prefer to use Microsoft Teams will be using OpenAI, and those who use G Suite will use BART. In a few years, I doubt that someone will be choosing one or the other just because of the underlying LLM. Perhaps the race isn't between OpenAI and Google after all, but rather between Microsoft and Google, as it has always been. So I hope you found this comparison helpful and informative. In the future videos, I will be diving even deeper into the new Vertex AI cloud infrastructure and showcasing the rest of the features that Google revealed and showing you how you can integrate them directly into your business processes. So if you'd like to stay updated with more deep dives and reviews like this, don't forget to subscribe.